This is a video for A-Level Maths. First of all, let's hear what some of our students have to say.
A-Level Maths follows on a lot from GCSE Maths. So while it's also familiar, it's quite challenging as well in the way that we you complete it. But as long as you read the question, you'll be fine.
I think maths, if nothing else, it's a challenge, but a welcome challenge, because if you enjoy maths, it's one thing to cope with maths, but if you enjoy it, there's no reason you can't do it really well.
Maths at Havant's really good because the teachers always explain the methods really clearly, and there's always support as well if you need it, either through emails or face-to-face.
At the Havant Campus, we teach OCR Mathematics A specification, H240. You will sit three papers in May and June of 2022. All three papers have pure content, which will include subjects that will be familiar to you, like algebra, trigonometry, and sequences. But you will also learn new subjects, such as calculus, parametric equations, logarithms, exponential functions, and numerical methods. The second paper has a section dedicated to statistics, where you will learn how to handle data, calculate probabilities, and use distributions to test hypotheses. The third paper has a section dedicated to mechanics, where you will use mathematical techniques to solve problems involving motion and forces. A-level mathematics is demanding. You will need at least a grade 6 at GCSE mathematics, but it would be preferable to have a grade 7 or above. Listed here are other courses that use mathematics, and students often take them alongside A-level maths. In particular, chemistry and especially physics will make use of some of the aspects of A-level maths. But the most important prerequisite is that you really enjoy the subject and are willing to put in the effort to succeed. You will need to bring your own writing materials to lessons with you. You should also have a file to organise your work into. Your maths lecturer will teach using the calculator shown here, and you will need to purchase it. It costs about £30 new. This has a suite of capabilities that are vital for the exam, and you must learn how to use it effectively. If you really enjoy maths and are thinking about doing a degree in maths, physics or engineering at university, then you should at least seriously consider doing further maths A-level as an additional course. For more information, please view our further maths video. By taking A-level mathematics, you will be extending your range of mathematical skills and techniques. Students often remark on how rewarding it is when they find they can solve really involved and difficult problems. But this is not always going to be an easy ride. There is a lot to learn, and you will need advanced problem-solving skills and be able to keep a cool focus when under pressured exam conditions. It is vital that you fully attend 5 hours of maths lessons every week, and you will need also to do 5 hours of homework a week to hone those skills. Throughout the course, you will need to be resilient and up for a challenge. Mathematics is a highly respected A-level. It develops your ability to calculate, analyse, and think critically. It has a staggering breadth of application, and our successful math students go on to join higher apprenticeships and study university degrees in a wide range of subjects. Thank you for taking the time to watch our virtual open evening page on A-level mathematics.
Hello, my name is John Rogers. I'm a A-level further mathematics teacher here at HSDC Havant, and I want to talk to you now about further mathematics as an A-level option that you might want to consider. What is further mathematics? It is a full A-level for the specialist mathematician. It is taken in addition to mathematics A-level, not instead of it. That's probably important to emphasise. In other words, if you take further mathematics A-level, you are taking two A-levels in mathematics. The standard mathematics A-level, which many more students take alone, and further mathematics on top. It supplements the A-level mathematics course by giving more depth and more variety. I often get asked if it's more challenging, which it probably is. If the pace is faster, it probably is. But I would certainly want to be emphasising the depth and variety in particular. There is a broad outline of the course content. It is not an exhaustive list by any means. Note that we are studying also pure mathematics, statistics and mechanics, so the broad areas are the same as in the main A-level course. Proportions are slightly different. I've listed some of the topics there which we cover in further mathematics, which we either don't do at all in the standard maths A-level course, such as complex numbers, or we do in much less depth, for example, correlation and regression. We follow the OCR A exam specification. Entrance requirements, grade 7, but to be honest, most of our students, being of a high achieving nature, taking two mathematics A-levels, have achieved an 8 or a 9 in mathematics. Often get asked, shouldn't I take 4, but seeing as two of my options are taken with maths, if I take further maths, it's certainly a viable option if you're very strong, if you have a very strong GCSE profile overall, not just in maths and science, and you can't really bear the idea of having to restrict yourself to just one other subject other than mathematics. But you certainly shouldn't feel like you have to do that. And some of our highest achieving students still only do 3 because that enables them to put more of their time and effort into their mathematics and then one other A-level that they've chosen. And you certainly shouldn't feel that that is in any way restricting if you want to go on to a mathematics related course later on. All of the universities really highly regard further mathematics as an A-level in its own right. Okay, there's a list of extension activities that we offer. That's not just for further mathematicians, but we've just chose it to put it here because it's true to say that our further mathematicians take advantage of these opportunities very much, in particular, very much so. Okay, so there's some common destinations that our students end up in, mathematics degree being a very common one. If you go on to want to do a mathematics degree, then you probably want to be doing further maths because even if the university doesn't insist on it, it's very highly regarded. We asked our students 3 questions prior to this presentation, just to get their feedback. Why do you choose further maths? What do you like about further maths? And what do you think you wish you'd known about further maths before you started? As this first question, you might want to pause the video at this point to take in some of those responses. A lot of talk about challenge and the pace of the course and the factor and university choices and such things. Second question, what did you like about further maths? Again, talk about content, mechanics and different subject areas. Again, talk of challenge and talk about the pace as well. And finally, what did you wish you'd known before you started further maths? The amount of work it's done. I like the fact that someone's actually responded in that way. We do emphasise the need to work hard. You're going to need to devote 10 hours of study on top of the 10 hours you do in class in order to be successful. In this course, the work ethic certainly needs to be strong and you need to really be quite committed. But some of the answers there are interesting about workload and challenge in general too. So that's it, nearly. I just wanted to finish on one further quotation from one of our students, which might best summarise why you might want to consider doing further maths. If you're passionate about maths and could see yourself doing maths every day and enjoying it, then go for it. It's very rewarding. So if that sounds like you, give further mathematics some thought. Okay, that's it, folks. Hope to see you in 2021. Bye. Can you hear the drum? There's a revolution coming.
A-Level Computer Science. This subject is an exploration into the world of computing and technology. If you enjoy technology, solving problems and changing the world, this is the subject for you. Come and join the revolution. Hi, I'm Danny Fellows, your computer science teacher. The A-Level in computer science is split into two main sections, programming and the theory of computer science. Programming is all about problem solving. Put yourself in control and learn to be the creator of the computer programs rather than just the user. Programming is great fun and brilliant for job prospects. We have a great computer lab and excellent technology. There are 20 computers in the room, so that's a maximum of 20 students in each class. The theory topics cover all aspects of computing and how it affects our lives. We look at robotics, bits, bytes and binary, networking and the internet, inside the computer, and much, much more. Assessment. We have two exams. Paper 1 is an online programming exam. It's 40% of the assessment. Paper 2 is a written theory exam. That's also 40% of the assessment. There's coursework, a programming project, which is 20% of the assessment. Here are some of the interesting, exciting computer science trips. Bletchley Park, Science Museum in London. The SSE Data Centre and Computer Centre, Portsmouth University Tech Base, and lots more. A-level computer science is a very popular subject. Great fun, creative, and very practical. Excellent with any other subject choice. Great place to meet like-minded people. Fantastic for your prospects of a great job. Come and join the revolution.